Hi, this is Coach Pomai for ICE Mental Game Training. Welcome to our podcast, After You Crash on the First Jump in Your Program. The skater stands, ready to go once the ice monitor opens the gate. Movement in the stands catches her eye, and she looks up. So many faces, so many more than usual. But this is to be expected. It's the qualifying round of a big competition. The announcer calls her name. She skates to center ice. She feels the anxiety building, but shakes her arm, her right leg, then her left leg. She takes a deep breath and exhales as she settles into her starting position. She has been preparing for this moment, begging for a clean skate, telling herself there is no room for mistakes. She pushes off and skates her opening transition across the rink into her backwards crossovers. Now for the first jump, a huge point getter, a triple Lutz. She proceeds into her pre-jump routine, setting up for the most difficult jump of her program. She travels backwards, exhales, picks, vaults, goes up, then crashes hard. A triple Lutz becomes a triple klutz. An audible groan of disappointment erupts from the crowd. A few clap to encourage her, but too late. Her confidence has fallen too. The poised, enthusiastic skater is gone. A defeated, sulking skater has taken her place. Now, she's just going through the motions, no hope for a clean skate. She has given up. She attempts a double axel, barely holds onto the landing, then steps out of a double-double combo, falls on the triple sal, and finally pops a flip. The crowd is just as anxious for the program to end as she is, for her sake. Not clean cut. It's easy to feel like you've failed after you make a mistake in your program, especially if you're convinced that a good skate means a clean skate. When this is your rule and you make a mistake, especially on the most important element in your program, you probably feel like giving up. Maybe you think, why bother? The points are gone and it's too late to get a good score. In reality, it's not as clear cut as that, or clean cut, if you will. Yes, if you don't land the first jump in your program, you can't skate clean. But skating a clean program is not the be-all and end-all of a good score. It's not logical to pin all your hopes on one element. There are 7, more or less, other elements in a program, and your score is the total of how you do each element in addition to your component score. It doesn't make sense to ignore them. Mistakes happen. But it is what you do after the mistake that separates the good skaters from the great. When you make a mistake, you might be down, literally and figuratively, but you are not out of the competition. It's elementary, my dear skater. This doesn't mean that you should not aspire to skate a clean program, but don't make it an expectation. When you expect to skate a clean program and you don't, then you might feel like you have failed. Remember that every element is very important and that each element gives you points. If you miss one, you still have other chances left to accumulate points. But if you give up, then you leave all those potential points on the ice, not to mention the points you get from the execution of your program. Yes, even when you change your mindset from should skate a clean program to shoot for a clean program, you will still feel nervous. This is a natural response in situations like big competitions or any competition. Nerves aren't a bad thing. Nerves are just your mind's way of regulating your attention and motivation about something you care deeply about. It can be unpleasant, but you can use it to your advantage. Let it push you to your fullest potential of achievement. Let it be like that slightly overbearing, in a good way, friend or parent who supports you unconditionally and who won't let you give up. How to implement the solution. Think of your competition program as a journey. Say you wanted to drive from Seattle to Los Angeles to see your favorite group in concert, and right out of your house, you got on the freeway going the wrong way. Instead of heading south, you're going north to Canada. Oh no, you or your parent made a mistake. Will you give up and go back home? Forget the trip? It's ruined, failed. Of course not. Chances are you'll find the first exit, turn around, and get headed in the right direction. In this example, it's absurd to even consider giving up, right? But this is exactly what you're doing when you give up on yourself after your mistakes in your program. Skating, like life, has ups and downs. But when you fail at something, you don't need to give up. A mistake doesn't define you or your life or your program. It adds to your story. You learn how to be better. If you're struggling with this, ask for help from others who have gone through the same thing or a professional who can give you feedback and guidance. You are hurting yourself with a limiting belief when you think that the only way to accumulate points is to nail the element with the most points. Start with these steps to get rid of this limiting belief. Number one, take a good look at your protocol from the last competition. Study the different elements such as spins, jumps, and footwork. Number two, look at the components to understand where you get points. You will see that there are many different ways to score points. Number three, make up your mind to skate each element the best that you can, to skate the whole program with your full attention. No more limits. When you throw out the limiting belief that one element matters more than everything else in your program, you can begin to balance your attention across the program. It is only then that you can begin to put the same amount of attention and motivation into practicing all parts of your program. This will lead to improvement in every part of your program. You will be a better skater and a more confident skater because you know that one mistake is not the end of the world. So don't limit your victory by limiting your belief. You can do this, one element at a time. It's your turn. Have you ever felt one element could make or break your program? Do you still believe it can? Shoot me an email. Thanks for listening. If you want to improve your mental game for competition or practice, download Confidence Mythbusters, a complimentary ebook from the link in the description box below. Oh, and please do me a favor and share this if you find it helpful. If you want to learn more, you can find us at icementalgame.com or like our page on Facebook at icementalgame. This is Coach Pomai reminding you that it takes mindfulness to reach excellence. Until next time, aloha and happy skating.